is Christmas season. A lot of people, let me not make the mistake of not letting you know, 25th of December is not when Jesus was born. 25th of December is not the birthday of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. It's a day that Christians, our fathers, let me put it that way, our fathers have decided that we should celebrate the birthday of Jesus. And this morning, I want to share with us about the reward of keeping your flocks by night. You don't just flocks, sheep. You don't just become a leader because you have been appointed or elected. A true leader is not whom has been appointed to lead. A true leader is somebody that people remember when they have challenges, when they have battles to solve. Praise the Lord. A true leader is one that his life and his life adventure have so much affected him, affected other people, and affected the community or his environment, that any time they have the same situation or battle, the first person they remember is that leader. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Church, I want to make sense.
Yes.
So, for you to get a reward, Bible says, why shepherds kept their flocks by night? Shepherds. A message of good news came. Can we read it? Just read it. Let's read Luke chapter 2 before we pray. Luke chapter 2, I start from verse 8. There were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch overnight, their flock by night. Now, before that, look at what happened. Verse 6. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should deliver. It was time for her to give birth to a child. Just at the same time. Look at what happened, verse 7. And she brought forth her first child, son, firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Verse 8. And there were, in the same country, Kabushke Pakura Makari Katayaba. There were in the same country shepherds abiding in their field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Verse 9. And lo, the angel of the Lord came unto them, and the glory of the Lord shone around about them, and they were so afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, fear not, for behold, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great news, which shall be to all. Let me read another version. And the angel said unto and said, have no fear, for truly I give you what? Good news. Good news of great joy, which will be for all the people. Church, what is the thing that God has given to us through the mouth of the angel of Church of God Mission? For us in December 2017. What is the thing? You can remember?
Good news.
Good news. Our month of good news. And look at what this place says. Lord, we thank you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the thanks. Thank you for this season. A season to remember, a season to celebrate. Be all the glory, be all the thanks and adoration in Jesus' name. Within the little minute, I'm going to explain this. Cause me to make a spiritual landmark that will remain indelible in our hearts. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Do you know why we don't appreciate most times? Do you know why? Like I rightly said, 25th of December is not the day Jesus was born. It's the day our fathers choose that we should celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I want to give you something that will help you in this life journey, if you will grab it. Do you know why we don't appreciate? Do you know why we don't reciprocate? With appreciation, one, because if you don't remember, it's because you don't remember. Now, you see, any success any man has made in life, listen very well, it's so true. If you see a successful person in life, that thing that person has achieved, he saturated it in his or her mind for a long time until it became a habit. Don't ever boast that I will really appreciate. Let's say somebody bless you and say, I will appreciate in the next coming years. And you didn't do anything about it. You just because he blessed you in 2000 and in 2000, and you won't appreciate in 2015, you just say, okay, I will remember. Forget it, you will never appreciate that person. Unless inadvertently, not consciously, inadvertently, something reminded you of that. If something doesn't remind you of that, you will never. So why do we appreciate? We appreciate because we remember. I'm coming, if you understand where I'm going. Don't say you will never appreciate somebody if you do not put something like a sign. That is why we have pictures. Have you ever wondered why Pastor Joseph cannot do anything without taking pictures? Have you ever wondered? Some people are so religious, so holy, that they don't take pictures. You are kidding yourself. You can never remember, you can never appreciate. It's hard for me in life not to appreciate anybody that has blessed me. Because immediately I get it, you bless it. Oh, this is a blessing. This is something good. I will write something. I will put something, sticker. I will make sure I will put it. I put a reminder to be reminding me. Why? Because this brain cannot work, function well without repetition, without saturation, without keep on speaking to it, without reminding it. That's why I love Facebook memory. It's hard for me. I'm telling you as a living witness. My wife here, she's here. Sometimes she's a living, as I should tell you, sometimes she gets angry with me appreciating. I'm telling you the truth. I know my wife, she's my wife. That's why I say, stop this, stop it. And I tell her, that's the difference between you and God. David said seven times every day, but I'm only three times I'm saying one thing. Thank you for the tea. Thank you for the coffee. I appreciate the coffee. Oh, the coffee is so sweet. The coffee. And that's what I'm drinking. Not because of the coffee, but because her hand prepared the coffee for me. Does that make sense? It's not the coffee, it is the power. my wife will warn me. And if she has the right to call the police on me, because you can't call police on me, for appreciating, I'm telling you the truth. Do you know why that happens in my life? Do you know why I keep on appreciating her for? I remember everything. It's not even what is happening. I remember people. Do you know, you see, Pastor Joseph, you think I've come to a level in life. I can't forget what one of my prayer partner, when I was growing as a youth, told me, a lady. You know, when I gave, God called me, I was declaring, I left clearing. The worst part of it was the girl that I wanted at that time to, I was in relationship with, I mean, not relationship, because she had not accepted yet. I was just trying to impress her. So she wanted to go back to school, University of Calabar. And she asked me for a certain amount of money. I've already left the business I was doing that was giving me a huge amount of money. My family was angry. My friends, they were angry. I said, you were seeing this before, now you left. I said, you are carrying the bag. So it happened that the last money that was left in my account, so she told me, I need to sign so I'm out. So she was just trying to know whether I'm qualified to be her husband. So that was, it was a big money. It was around 2,000 naira, 3,000. So you know, I promised her that I have such account in as someone that amount in my account, and that was the last money that I will give you the money. And it was on Sunday that I promised to give her the money. But I came to the church with the money. And the church needed to buy a bank instead of bank. So the money I came to give my somebody I wanted to marry. It was a need in the house of the Lord. I gave that money to the church. When she now came to me and said, where is the money you promised? And then she knows I can't lie. I said, I came to the church with the money. What, stop preaching about buying a bank for the church. I gave the $2,000. You know what the lady told me? She said, you want to marry? You can't buy a bank. Only 2,000 I asked, you can't even buy a lady's bank and you want to marry. When I turned to my prayer partner, I said, look at what this girl told me. He said, thank God that there is a woman that can start and tell a fine boy like you, a young woman, bright boy like you, that I cannot marry you. Men are so proud. It's only men that are telling women, you know, get out, I don't want to marry. Does that make sense? I don't know. My friend told me, he said, it's good that for the first time I hear that the woman bullshit, you know. What is it, bullshit? Shit and boo. That's what I'm talking about. It's not whatever slang. I'm talking about the shit of boo. Not the slang, American slang, Australian slang, because I don't know what that means. Just like when I came to Australia new, we were doing conference and somebody said, oh my gosh! I said, excuse me? Say, oh my gosh! I said, I'm from Africa. I don't understand. What are you calling God, gosh? Are you calling the God that I'm serving, gosh? That was in Queensland when we went for a conference. John Allen conference. I said, are you calling, you know, so Elijah with Elijah 19? I was so angry. I said, oh my gosh. I said, are you calling God gosh? He said, no, that's just a slap. So that's the same way I'm saying. I don't know what they mean by bullshit, but the one I'm talking about is a poo and a shit. Church, I'm telling you something. So how is it that I appreciate my wife 100 times? Do you know the same lady I'm talking about? Because in church, tithe card is placed in the church. The lady goes to check my tithe card. She goes to check, you know, I paid tithe. The tithe I was paying that time, 300 naira. I wasn't working, I wasn't getting any income. But the girl will go and check my tithe and show her friends, you know, go to the tithe boss. Look at the girl that want to marry me. But I'm telling you, the situation I was then was worse when I met my wife. And my wife is a princess. She came from a royal family. So when I see all these things, I don't just see now. I remember. Are you understanding where I'm going? You can never appreciate if you don't remember. You can never appreciate if you don't remember. You can never appreciate God if you don't remember. You can never appreciate your partner if you don't remember. You can never appreciate anything. That is why we are remembering God. We are remembering the birth of Christ every 25th of December. So that we appreciate. Am I telling stories or just entertaining you? Or making sense? I don't, if there's nothing, I'm not interested in appreciating anybody. I'm interested in remembering what that person has done for me. I tell you, you might not be moved to appreciate now, but there's a time. I have pictures. I don't throw my pictures away. People that are myopic, I will remember in my brain. I will remember. Is it now? That is why every year Christians have agreed to remember. And that was the only thing Jesus asked. A lot of us, it's not as if we don't want to appreciate. It's as if it's because we have not remembered, we have not celebrated, we have not kept some records about. Was that my sense? Let me tell you. If you don't live the life of appreciation, you will depreciate in life. You will be thinking you are making effort. You are making no effort. Why you keep on not appreciating people? It's because you don't remember. And don't keep record of bad things. Keep record of good. Are you getting the point? Keep record. If the record of bad is to be kept, it's so that you avoid the same thing that happened not to happen again. Look at it. The secret of the Lord is with those that fear him. Look at this shepherd. I've had ministers. Why is it that I called you the night your phone was off? He said, Pastor Joseph. No. Pastor Joseph. I'm sleeping. I have to rest. Let me tell the church. If you think that is only comfort position that you achieve great things is a lie. You achieve great things when it's not comfortable. In the night. Let me tell you, if you are expecting a miracle, if you want something to change in your life, I call junior pastors, they have not even achieved anything. They've not. Pastor, have to sleep. Sleep? Have to sleep? Really? I say your greatest miracle comes by night. This is a month of good news. Thank God this month, this year is ending on a Sunday with an honor. This year is ending with the first day of the week. It's very significant. It's the most significant if it ended with the last day of the week. But now that it's ending with the first day, Tabushki brother, it means that 2017 is joined with 2018. Whatever you achieve in 2017, you're going to achieve it double in 2018. That's just what God is saying. Wherever He has positioned you to get breakthrough, to catch breakthrough in 2017, He's saying 2018 is coming with a bigger one. It's linked. We have to tell each other. What price are you paying for your future? You know, Christianity has messed up the whole thing. Christianity has messed up the status quo. Don't worry, son, we've tried our best. Christianity has messed up the status quo. Yeah. But it still remains. Jesus is saying yesterday and today and forever.
Yes.
I challenge you. Don't leave this place without putting something that will always make you remember what Jesus has done for you. And you know what? The joy that I get anytime my wife says, "Stop disturbing me. What is all this thing? What did I give you? This, that. You brought the money to buy it, and this, that. La, la, la." You know what I say? I say, because I can't. You know, I don't love my wife more than God. I love God more than my wife. And I'm telling you, if I give my wife, I appreciate my wife 10 times. I appreciate Jehovah 1,000,000 times. Is that she knows? I live a life of appreciation. And I don't live it because I want to live it. Because if you do what I do, you will see you live also the life of appreciation.